How do we know how far the stars are? Alright, so you have this sky full of stars at night and we know they are several light years away. Tens of trillions of kilometers, if you will. As of currently, no one has ever covered a distance even remotely close to that. The average distance a human travels during their lifetime is 180,000 kilometers, which is just about halfway to the moon. This is less than a millionth of a single light year. Not even spacecraft like Voyager 1 come even remotely close to this with their 22 billion kilometers of travel distance. Because this is still only slightly more than a thousandth of a light year. The stars are far, very far away. But how exactly did we figure that out? Today we are going to take a look at how we know how far the stars are. To figure out how far a star is, we use the parallax method. Parallax is the visual effect produced when, as an observer moves, nearby objects appear to shift position relative to more distant objects. This common event is easily reproduced. Hold your finger out at arm's length and look at your fingertip first with one eye closed, then the other. The motion of your fingertip as seen against the background objects is caused by the change in your viewing position, about 7 cm from one eye to the other. As you switch back and forth between your right and left eye, you see the background shifting behind your finger. This is the parallax phenomenon doing its work. Stellar parallax is most often used using the difference in position of a star as seen from the Earth and the Sun. As the Earth orbits the Sun, astronomers evoke the same principle to determine the distance to nearby stars. Just like your fingertips, stars that are closer to us shift positions relative to more distant stars. By carefully measuring the angle through which the stars appear to move over the course of the year and knowing how far the Earth has moved, astronomers are able to use basic high school geometry to calculate the star's distance. Parsec, 3.26 light years, is defined as the distance for which the annual parallax is 1 arc second. Annual parallax is normally measured by observing the position of a star at different times of the year as the Earth moves through its orbit. The first successful measurements of stellar parallax were made by Friedrich Bessel in 1838 for the star 61 Cygni using a heliometer. The first well-recorded observation of 61 Cygni was by James Bradley in 1753. In 1792, Giuseppe Piazzi noticed the high proper motion when he compared his own observations of 61 Cygni with those of Bradley made 40 years earlier. Piazzi noticed that this motion meant that it was probably one of the closest stars, and suggested it would be a prime candidate for an attempt to determine its distance through parallax measurements. By the 1830s, there was a fierce competition between astronomers to be the first to measure a stellar parallax accurately and determine the scale of interstellar distances. In 1830, Friedrich Bessel won the race, announcing that 61 Cygni had a parallax of 0.314 arc seconds, which, given the diameter of Earth's orbit, indicated that the star is 97.44 trillion kilometers away. It was a few trillion kilometers off, but still. So at the time, was it a big shock to find out just how vast interstellar differences are? The distance, though vast, wasn't really a big shock, as most astronomers had already been toying with inaccurate parallax measurements for decades before. By 1838, the fact interstellar distances were several trillion kilometers wasn't really a surprise anymore. From this year on, stellar distances were faster and easier calculated every year. In the 1990s, the Hipparcos satellite used the parallax method to calculate the distance to over 118,000 stars. In 2013, the Gaia satellite followed this by insanely calculating the distance to over 1 billion stars. And this is how we figured out the distance to the stars.